Hello and welcome to your English language class. Today in this class we'll be taking up the worksheet number 6 from your English Junction workbook, and the title of this worksheet is William Decides to Help. So this is a story about a little boy William who wanted to be of some help in shifting the furniture to their new house. He was asked by his mother not to disturb the movers and packers, but he had made up his mind that he would help them in one way or the other. So let's read the story to find out, does William actually help or did he just make a mess out of all the things? So William was feeling rather bored. Having nothing else to do, he began to listen to what the elders were talking about. So William was getting bored and he had nothing else to do, so he decided, okay fine, let me just check out what the elders are doing and what are they discussing or talking about. They promised to be here by 9, Mrs. Brown, his mother, was saying. I do hope they won't be late. Now Mrs. Brown and William's mother, okay, she is talking about the movers and packers who are supposed to be there at his house, at William's house, by 9 o'clock in the morning. So she is also hoping that the movers and packers are right on time and they shouldn't be late. Well, their coming won't help much. If the other house isn't ready, will it? Said William's grown-up sister, Ethel. I don't believe they have even finished painting. So William's elder sister, Ethel, says that I don't think that whether the movers and packers, if they come on time, will it help or not, because I don't think the new house is ready to move in, okay, because still the painting work is going on there. So she is saying that I don't believe they have even finished painting there. I'm so sorry, it's a holiday for William today, sighed Mrs. Brown. So Mrs. Brown was already tensed and she just says in a very sad tone that she's so sorry that it's a holiday for William that day, and otherwise William would have been at school and he won't be disturbing them. He'll be in the way. So she is more worried that William will be disturbing the shifting process. William's face became very cheerful. Are they coming to move our furniture this morning? He inquired. Now he was very inquisitive child and he wanted to know a lot of things. So William just asked cheerfully that are they here is movers and packers. So he just inquired that are they really coming to move our furniture this morning? Yes, do try not to disturb them, William. So uski mother kehti hai ki tum unhe disturb mat karna. Okay, me, he said indignantly, as if he is very much surprised or shocked, okay, after listening to what his mother commented just now. I'm not going to disturb them, rather I'm going to help them. Okay, he just said, I'm going to help. So 10 minutes later, Mrs. Brown found the steps of the front door covered with small ornaments. She stared in confusion. Just then, William appeared from the drawing room, staggering under the weight of a little statue. Okay, so what happened after 10 minutes? Mrs. Brown found a lot of things kept on the steps or the staircase of her house. So she got a little confused that what was happening and who was putting all those things there. And just then William, he just appeared from the drawing room and he was just walking with great difficulty because he was holding a little statue which was quite heavy for him. He was just a little boy. Okay. It was extremely valuable and had been the property of Mr. Brown's great-grandfather. Okay, now that statue was quite precious as it used to belong to his father, William's father's great grandfather. Okay. William, she gasped. Okay, so she shouted in horror that, "William, what are you doing? You'll break the statue." "I'm getting all the little things ready for them just to carry straight down. If I put everything on the steps, they don't need to come into the house at all. You said you didn't want them moving around the house in dirty boots." Now he's being quite thoughtful here. William is trying to help his mother, and he knew that his mother is quite very obsessed with cleanliness. Okay, so he wanted to help his mother in keeping the house clean. And he just thought that if I keep all the things on the staircase, then the movers and packers, they won't have to enter the house, and they can just pick the things up from the staircase and just shift the entire furniture from there itself without entering the house, without making the house dirty with their dirty boots. It took a quarter of an hour to replace all the items that William had brought down. So it took almost 45 minutes to keep all those things back from where William had taken them to the staircase. Over the fragments of a blue crystal bowl, Mrs. Brown sighed deeply. Now, as he was shifting the things, what happened? He just broke one blue crystal bowl, and it was quite dear to his mother, Mrs. Brown. So she just said disappointedly, "I wish you'd broken anything but this, William." ओके, अब वो बहुत निराश हो जाती हैं, बहुत अपसेट हो जाती हैं कि तुमने तुमने और कुछ तोड़ा होता तो मुझे इतना दुख नहीं होता, बट दिस वॉज़ माई फेवरेट एंड यू ब्रोक दैट ब्लू क्रिस्टल बोल. वेल, ही एक्सक्यूज हिम सेल्फ. अब उसने क्या जस्टिफिकेशन दिया, क्या एक्सक्यूज़ दिया? यू सेड थिंग्स डू गेट ब्रोकन वाइल मूविंग. आप ही तो कहती हो कि जब भी हम सामान शिफ्ट करते हैं तो कुछ चीज़ें टूट भी जाती हैं. यू सेड सो योर सेल्फ. आपने खुद ही कहा था. आई डिडंट ब्रेक इट ऑन पर्पज, आई डिडंट डू इट इंटेंशनली. इट वॉज नॉट माई इंटेंशन टू ब्रेक दैट ब्लू क्रिस्टल बोल. इट जस्ट गॉट ब्रोकन वाइल मूविंग. सो बिकॉज आई वॉज शिफ्टिंग थिंग्स, इट जस्ट ब्रोक डाउन. ओके, एंड इट वॉज नॉट समथिंग विच आई डिड इंटेंशनली. सो दिस इज द स्टोरी, विलियम डिसाइड्स टू हेल्प. ओके, ऐसा होता है ना, छोटे बच्चे ऐसा ही करते हैं. उनको मना भी किया जाए किसी काम के लिए, बट वो बहुत ज़्यादा एकदम थोड़ा रिस्पॉन्सिबली बिहेव करना चाहते हैं. वो चाहते हैं कि हम भी बड़ों की तरह किसी काम में हेल्प करें, लेकिन उनकी हेल्प कई बार महंगी पड़ जाती है. राइट, सो इट्स अ गुड थॉट दैट दे आर बीइंग रियली हेल्पफुल एंड दे आर ट्राइंग टू बी हेल्पफुल. बट यस, वी शुड एनकरेज देम एंड वी शुड टेल देम वॉट एग्जैक्टली नॉट टू डू एंड वॉट एग्जैक्टली दे शुड डू. राइट, हमें पूरा अच्छे से उनको एक्सप्लेन कर देना चाहिए, उन्हें समझा देना चाहिए, देन ओनली दे विल बी एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड. राइट, सो लेट्स डू द क्वेश्चन आंसर्स गिवन हियर. पिक आउट लाइन्स फ्रॉम द टेक्स्ट विच टेल यू दैट. फर्स्ट इज, विलियम वॉजेंट यूजली इंटरेस्टेड इन द कॉन्वर्सेशन ऑफ एल्डर्स. सो विच लाइन टेल्स अस दैट? हैविंग नथिंग एल्स टू डू, ही बिगेन टू लिसन टू वॉट एल्डर्स वर टॉकिंग अबाउट. ओके, सेकेंड इज, द ब्राउन्स वर मूविंग टू अ न्यू हाउस दैट वॉजेंट रेडी येट. सो वेल, देयर कमिंग वोंट हेल्प मच इफ द अदर हाउस इज इंट रेडी, विल इट? हु सेड दीज लाइन्स? विलियम्स एल्डर सिस्टर इथेल सेड दीज लाइन्स, एंड दीज लाइन्स शो दैट द न्यू हाउस वॉज नॉट रेडी येट. द स्टैचू वॉज टू हैवी फॉर विलियम. हाउ कैन वी से दिस? विलियम अपियर्ड फ्रॉम ड्राॅइंग रूम स्टैगरिंग अंडर द वेट ऑफ अ लिटल स्टैचू. ओके, डोंट जस्ट कॉपी दीज आंसर्स विच आर रिटन हेयर. ओके, हेयर अ फ्यू स्पेलिंग मिस्टेक्स आर ऑल्सो देयर, सो जस्ट डोंट कॉपी इट फ्रॉम हेयर. वट एवर आई एम सेइंग, जस्ट नोट डाउन एंड राइट इट इन योर ओन वर्ड्स. Fourth is the little statue was very old. Okay, so it was extremely valuable and had been the property of Mr. Brown's great grandfather. Okay. Next is, William had thought of a plan to prevent the furniture movers from walking in the house wearing dirty boots. If I put everything on the steps, they don't need to come into a house at all. You said you didn't want them moving around the house in boots, right? In dirty boots. Okay. And the last one is, William had broken an object to pieces. I wish you had broken anything but this, William. Okay. So all these lines from the text tell you that this is what was happening in the story. Okay. So just do all these question answers and read the story once again. Okay. And we'll be taking up the grammar portion given here in the next video. Okay. So just submit your homework, and thank you for watching this video.